What's up, vinyl community? Jazz lovers, Blue Note lovers. My name is Kieran. For those of you that follow my channel, you're probably familiar with this Blue Note project. It's been going on, this epic project. And for those of you that are tuning into my channel for the first time as a result of following this project, welcome. I'm honored, to participate, to contribute to this. It's overdue. I slacked on a couple of the earlier titles that didn't necessarily speak to me as much, but this particular title is one that I pinpointed and said that I would like to tackle. So here it is, Saturday night, beautiful Saturday afternoon, evening. Spring's in the air, even though it's still minus 10 here today, but sunny, time change tonight. Cheers. Thank you to everyone who's participated in the project. Not that I have to thank you, but thank you in the sense of all the great content. Everyone's done a great job. There's a lot of people that I didn't follow before and some I haven't checked out. There's just so many videos. It's really great work by, and I don't, Sherv and Dave and all the other contributors, James has done one, Lavelle, Digital Gramophone. I mean, the list goes on. There's ton, but it's just pretty cool. And now the 1500 series is going. So let's get into it. Pretty honored to get to tackle this one because it's a pretty special one. So the title today, Blue Note 4169, Lee Morgan, Search for the New Land. And this is... particularly the title track, a very, very special record. So this was recorded, well, so just to backtrack a little, this Lee, recorded, I think this is his eighth album for Blue Note, and six of them came, late 50s, early 60s, and then he kind of took some time away from playing, from recording, because of his heroin addiction. And I think he went somewhere, I can't remember where, to, recover. And then he came back with the Sidewinder. So he recorded the Sidewinder, which is kind of probably one of the best-selling, if not, Blue Note albums of all time, I would imagine. But in December 63, you know the story with that. And this was recorded in February 64. Sidewinder didn't actually come out until July of that, of 64, of the year this was recorded, and this didn't come out until 1966, I think it was July, so not till 2 years later, after the Sidewinder kind of mania, the popularity of that, and I believe Rump Roller came out as well before this, but they did release it 2 years later after it was recorded with the original catalog number. So, as we know with Blue Note, not necessarily released in order of catalog number. And the title really says a lot here. Search for the New Land. You really feel it in this. So obviously you have Lee Morgan on trumpet, Wayne Shorter on tenor sax, who they played together or in the early years, the VJ years, and I believe with Blakey. Grant Green on guitar, Herbie Hancock on piano, Reggie Workman on bass, and Billy Higgins on drums. I believe it's their first time recording together. I could be wrong. Herbie Hancock and Lee Morgan, and potentially Grant Green and Lee Morgan as well. I know Billy Higgins was there on the Sidewinder and for many subsequent recordings, and Grant Green really adds a lot to me. I can't think of another Lee Morgan record with a guitarist. I don't know that there is one. And I mean, obviously there is an intention here to be very different in the title track than anything he had done before, but the element of the guitar adds a lot to that. It's not just the guitar that makes it different, like I'm saying, but It just, the mood is completely different on this, and the guitar, Grant Green, works perfectly within that. So there's five tracks on this, the title track being the first one, which is a 15 minute masterpiece. I'll get more into that. Followed by a shorter track on side to finish off side one, and then side two, three tracks, Mr. Kenyatta, Melancholy, Morgan the Pirate. And all five are Morgan originals. So Search for the New Land is, for me, what makes this. The whole album is great. The musicians work beautifully together. They're totally in sync. It's really something. But the title track is so good and so beautiful and takes you somewhere. And unlike any other track that I've heard that I can think of, it leaves me wanting more. I mean, 15 minutes is plenty, but when you hear the other songs, which are great, they're just very different than Search for the New Land, that I wish there was maybe, like, you know, I would have taken just Search for the New Land on side one, and then another track, not necessarily the same, but more in that style, on side two. Not taking away, the whole album's great, that's just me being picky. So Search for the New Land is just this moody, expressive track. And it's really, there's elements of, so they all have, in their solos is where you really hear a difference. Like, particularly Morgan, when he was younger, he would come out, he was fiery, he would like blast at you. And there's something different in his playing here. It's more thoughtful, it's more emotional, it's less like trying to in your face show off how good you are. It's more introspective in him, kind of, I guess, looking inwards, he's searching for something, whether he's found it or not. I'm not sure, and I don't know what that is, but there's some magic here. And what I do find interesting is the mood is very evident right from the get-go, this kind of mysterious vibe. However, the theme they keep coming back to, it always starts, you know, you have your solo, and then there's Reggie comes in on bass, and then Herbie comes in with the piano, and the piano riff, which is the theme, to me is reminiscent of the popular kind of sound that you hear on Sideway. It has that kind of groovy feel to it, but they just keep they transform it, and then they come back to it. They transform it and they come back to it. And it's really interesting. And Grant Green, this is where he really notices it, that him coming in and just popping up with his plucking on the guitar, it adds a whole other element to the vibe, to the moodiness even of it. Lee's solo, the way it ends is so expressive. It's slow. It's just you have to listen to it to know, and you have to repeated listens. And I wish what I could have done, I didn't have time, is I listened to this quite a bit, and I'm not great at remembering and describing like each solo and the notes, but to kind of compare it to some other albums, which I haven't listened to many other Lee albums recently, and especially not with the same intention as I've listened to this one. But yeah, so there it is. That's Search for the New Land. Wayne Shorter is like kind of, it's a modal feel on this. So reminiscent of Coltrane a bit, with the tone and the style, definitely not the same, but that it's a mix of the grooviness with a modal, sometimes Eastern feel, and then the next track, The Joker, is more of just a beautiful playing, but not the same vibe at all, more of kind of a straight ahead, a hard bop track. Mr. Kenyatta, which is, I didn't know, but was the first Prime Minister of Kenya in 1963. So I guess it's an ode to him. That's kind of more of a high energy track, high energy groover. My second favorite track would be Melancholy. which is a slower number. Also, again, more more introspective, and not in the sense of like a ballad that you would always have. It's different than the slower tracks you would have on the albums in the 50s and the early 60s. And I love Herbie on this, honestly. Grant Green and Herbie Hancock. Herbie on, I think it's the last track, Morgan the Pirate. He just comes in and out, just plays a little bit here, a little bit there. He's not playing throughout, and it's just, it adds this element, which is this vibe to the track, which I love. I'm gonna give you a little taste of my, like, just the intro. I'm sure you've heard this, but just the way the album starts gives you right away, you know you're in for something different. Part of the energy that they're creating here and what makes it different. And different than what you hear on, you know, Grant Green's own album. But what I wanna, so there we're into Wayne solo. But this is the kind of groovy. Just isolate this part. With Herbie's piano. And then you get into the solos and we're off. Okay, so that's pretty much it. I mean, if you don't know this, it's met by many people considered, you know, one of their favorite of the Morgan catalog. Obviously, it's a sign of things to come. He did. By no means is this in the new thing, and some of the Blue Note albums we've gotten through already in the series, and some of them are still to come, but the more adventurous ones, this is not out there in that way. It's different in a whole other way that is not the new thing. And I think that's what makes this very special, in just for jazz in general, but particularly for Blue Note, the Blue Note catalog, and in Lee Morgan's catalog. Sadly, we lost him too early, and the stuff he was doing in the 70s was really kind of stretching out a bit, and this track was the first sign of that. And, you know, it's sad. But this, just to talk about the physical aspect of this is a stereo pressing. So this, like I said, it was released in 66. So the initial release of this was, still by Blue Note Records, and, before the sale to Liberty. There are mono and stereo copies that exist, I believe, with the Plastilite P. Shortly thereafter, we know the story of it being sold to Liberty. My copy is, New York, pressing, but without the P, so it would have been an early Liberty pressing after the sale, where they're using up old labels, and old jackets and stuff. So really, really happy to have this. My copy's extremely clean, sounds great. I've never heard the mono. I'm curious how that might change the experience, or you know, make it a little different, but. This is something I found locally here in Montreal a few years ago, and a cherished part of my Blue Note collection and just my jazz collection as a whole. There is a little punch there and a little check mark, but nothing that bothers me. So that's it. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for, you know, inviting me to participate in this great project. And once again, if you don't know this album, go check it out. close the lights, close your eyes, just immerse yourself in the sounds and the search for the new land, whatever that is to you. Whatever's happening in your life right now, this is some powerful, some healing music. Go get it. Peace.